This is lesson 17 homework of module 7, grade 2. I'm going to write my name. Do that first so you don't forget it later. Date if you need to. It says estimate the length of each item by using a mental benchmark. I'll talk about that in a minute. Then measure the item using feet, inches, or yards. Now, a mental benchmark is something that you know how long it is already. So you can imagine how many of them it would take to measure something, or how many, or how much longer or how much shorter something is. And I'll give you a few examples on this page as we go. The items that you're gonna measure in your house are gonna be different. So your answers aren't going to be the same as mine, but my answers, they should be good examples for you. So let's talk about the length of a bed. And for a length of a bed, we're talking about the long side of a bed. Length is usually long, the longest of a side of a rectangle, and the width, this is the width of a rectangle, if it's a rectangular bed, the width of the bed is going to be how far across it is, because it's the shorter side of the rectangle. So shorter. So my mental benchmark, for example, it's going to be something that I know about how long it is. So for my mental benchmark for the length of a bed, I could have my mom lie down on the bed. And if I know my mom is about 5 feet tall, then I can look at the bed and look at her lie down on the bed and say, like, wow, that it looks like there's some room above her head and there's some room below her feet. So it's a little more than, the bed's definitely longer than my mom. So if my mom's 5 feet tall, and I'll draw a little picture here. Here's my mom lying down on the bed. There's her feet and her arms. And I'm thinking, well, that's 5 feet. Then there's a little room below her feet and maybe another foot there, another foot there. So I'm going to estimate if my mom's 5 and it's maybe 2 more feet for the rest of the bed, I'm going to guess that the bed is 7 feet. It's 7 feet. And then the actual length of the bed, I'm going to measure that with a tape measure, or I'm going to measure it with a ruler, just taking the ruler and moving it. So if it's a foot long, a 12-inch ruler, then you've got a foot. You can use that to count how many feet long the bed is. And it turns out that this bed that I have in mind, yours may be different, it actually is 7 feet. It's almost 7 feet. So if I'm rounding up or down, it's closer to 7 feet than 6 or 8, so I'm going to call it 7. Now the width of the bed, I can look at this and I can use the length of the bed as a benchmark. And I'm looking at how wide the bed is, and I'm thinking the bed looks about half as wide as it is long. So I'm thinking, what's half of 7? Well, I mean, it's a half of 7 is hard. So what if it was 6? Half of 6 would be 3, because 3 plus 3 is 6. So I could use my mental benchmark here would be the length of the bed. I could say the length of the bed. Now that I know how the it's 7 feet long. I could also use something smaller, like, you know, looking at this piece of paper right here, and say, well, I know that a piece of paper is 11 inches, it's almost a foot. So I could say, well, it looks like it might take 3 of them to get across the bed, or maybe 4. And think, all right, so maybe it's going to definitely take more than 3. So it might be 4. And 4 would be half of 8. So I'm like, okay, I'll go with that. So let's say, I'm going to estimate that it's 4 feet. That it's 4 feet wide. And then when I measure it, I'm going to use a tape measure or a ruler, and moving the ruler and counting, if that's what I'm going to do. And I found out that actually it's wider than that. It's actually 5 feet. So I can see that. It's actually 5 feet long. Now, your estimation and your actual length are not really supposed to be the same. Sometimes they are. If you make a lucky guess, then they will be the same. But or if you have a really good mental benchmark, sometimes it's easier to get it the same. But really, I mean, that's pretty close. That's a good estimation. You just an estimation is a guess. You're trying to get it close, and that's all it is. And it's not supposed to be the same. Don't go back and fix this so that all your estimations are the same. Don't do that. You just want them to be close. The height of a table, I could use something like a piece of paper and think, you know, how many pieces of paper tall is that table? The length of a table, I could do the same kind of thing. You know, for the length of a table, you could think, you know, about how long is your shoe? If you think your shoe is about a foot long, and then you could think, well, you know, how many, you could kind of put your shoes end to end and think, that's about so many feet. But we're not usually that like measuring, we're estimating. Well, here's an example for the length of a book. So yeah, you'll have different answers for the height of your table and the length of whatever table you choose to estimate. But those are some ideas for a mental benchmark. A piece of paper is a good one. For the length of a book. So here's an idea. I'm going to use this book right here. So I'm looking at this book, and I'm going to use a quarter for a mental benchmark. Quarter's about an inch. You want to pick something that's close to that either you know how many feet or inches it is, or it's close to a unit of measurement. So a quarter is about an inch. It's actually a little bit less. And I'm going to make a guess at how many quarters long this book is from here to here. And I'm going to guess, you know, it might be 10. I think it might be a little bit more than 10. I'm going to guess it's 11 quarters long. So my mental benchmark for the length of this book is a quarter. And since a quarter is about the same as an inch, and I guessed 11 quarters, I'm going to guess 11 inches. And now I'm going to actually measure the book in inches, not centimeters. So let's see. And it turns out it's 7, and this is the half mark here. So when it's right on the half mark, the halfway mark, then you go to the next one up. We always round up when it's on right exactly half. So I'm gonna call it 8. The actual length of the book is 8 inches. And here I estimated over, but 11 and 8, they're not that far apart. So there's nothing wrong with that estimation. Leave it there. You know, if that was what you estimated, then leave your estimation the way it was. We don't want to just fix everything so all our estimations are perfect. That's not an estimation. Now here's an example, another one. The length of your pencil on the second page. So here's my pencil. Now I'm thinking, wait a minute. That pencil is really close to the book. It's just a little bit less than the book. And my measurement of the book was 8 inches, and the pencil's a little bit less. So I'm going to say that the pencil, so my mental benchmark is the book. And sometimes you can put the things right next to each other and compare. And that's the best kind of mental benchmark that you can use. And I know that the book was 8 inches, and the pencil's a little bit less, so I'm going to guess the pencil is 7. 7 IN abbreviate inches, 7 inches. And now I'm going to measure the pencil. And the pencil is 7 inches. So I made a pretty lucky guess that time, and I had a good mental benchmark to use. I managed to have something on hand that was really close. So of course, if I had used this pencil a lot more, it'd be a lot shorter, and it wouldn't work out that way. And if it was a brand new pencil, it would probably be longer. But so the actual length 7 inches. So right now, for the other ones, I'm not gonna make a video showing you how to measure a refrigerator or estimate the length of your refrigerator. But when we're talking about length and height, it can get a little tricky. So I'm gonna draw a picture of a refrigerator here to show which dimensions we're talking about. So here's the front of a refrigerator, here's the door handle. Maybe you got a freezer on top and there's got its own handle here. And different refrigerators look different, but this is the idea, is that the height is the distance up from the floor to the top. And that's the height of a refrigerator. Now when we're talking about the length of a refrigerator, I'm gonna draw the picture. Now you don't have to draw this picture of the refrigerator, you don't. This is just to make sure you know what it is you're supposed to measure. And that's a crazy looking handle. Here's my handle. All right, now refrigerator doesn't have just height, it has three dimensions. It has height, which is how tall it is up from the floor, but it also has width and length. So whichever one of these two is longer, this how far across it is across the front, that is probably going to be the length, L. So that's probably what you're going to measure for the length of your refrigerator, is how far it is across from one side to the other. Going back, this would be probably the width. Whichever one is longer, it's probably going to be the distance across the front of the refrigerator. So measure that for your length. And then height is going to be how far up from the floor it is to the top of the refrigerator. And here's an idea, your mental benchmark for the height. You could have your dad or somebody, I'm going to have my dad stand next to it. And if I know my dad is about 6 feet tall, I can guess that the refrigerator is. And if my refrigerator is about the same height as my dad, maybe it's a little bit taller. It looks a little bit taller, but I think it's pretty close. So I could just say if I know my dad is 6 feet tall and refrigerator is pretty close to the same size as my dad, I could say that my refrigerator, maybe it's a little bit taller. I'll guess my refrigerator is 7 feet tall. And then measure your refrigerator. Now maybe your dad's different than mine. Maybe he's 5 feet tall or close, maybe somewhere in the middle. But you could use, you can use people as mental benchmarks. Just like you used your mom. Like I use my mom for the bed. I could have my dad stand next to the refrigerator and say he's about, we need to make room for his legs here. Here's my dad, and then the refrigerator is about that much taller than him. And if he's 6, then it's a little bit more and call it 7. And then measure it and see what it is. And the length of the sofa, same thing. Have him lie down on the sofa. And then see if it's longer or shorter and guess how much longer or shorter. That's a mental benchmark.